Hello everyone, today in this video you will learn what are sir, second thing how to find the lowest rationalizing factor and third is how to rationalize the denominator. Now we will begin with first point, what is it? What are sir? So first topic is sir. So what are sir? If the square root or cube root of any positive rational number is irrational, then we will call it as a surd. What I said? If the square root, cube root, etc. of any positive rational number is irrational, then it is called surd or radical. Let's see one example. Suppose I have taken here square root of 3. This 3 is the positive rational number. This 3 is positive rational number, and second thing is square root of 3 is irrational number. Both the condition are satisfying here. First condition is this 3 is a positive rational number, and second thing is square root of this positive rational number is irrational. That's why we will call that root 3 is a surd. So like this you have to identify whether the given number is a surd or not. Now we will solve some question based on this topic, surd. See question number first of your textbook. Exercise first, see question number first. In question number first part, square root of 180 is... So first of all we have to check whether this 180 is positive rational number or not. So first of all what you have to write? 180 is a positive rational number. This condition is satisfying here. This 180 is a positive rational number. Now we will find the square root of 180. Square root of 180, first of all we have to find the prime factor of 180 in rough. So these two and these two will come outside the root, that means 2 into 3, and this single term we will write inside root, that means 6 root 5 is coming. What is coming here? 6 root 5. What is 6 root 5? 6 root 5 is not, 6 root 5 is a irrational number. So what we are observing here, question is square root of 180. 180 is the positive rational number, and when we had find the square root of 180, answer is coming 6 root 5. 6 root 5 means it is the irrational number, or we can say it is not rational. So both the condition are satisfying here. First condition, 180 should be positive rational number. Okay. And second condition, square root of 180 should be irrational. That is also coming. So we can say it is a surd. See one more part. Part number 6th. Cube root of minus 125. Cube root of minus 125. Minus 125 prime factor, if you will find, this will become cube root of minus 5 into minus 5 into minus 5. On solving it, we will get the final answer 5. This is the cube root. In cube root, these three numbers we have to write single time when we will take it outside the root. So final answer is minus 5. What is this minus 5? Minus 5 is not an irrational number. So cube root of minus 125 answer is minus 5. It is not irrational number. And second thing, this is not a positive rational number also. For third, two conditions we have to check. First condition is the given number should be positive rational number. So you have to write here, and minus 125 is not a positive rational number also. Both the condition are not satisfying here, so we will call it is not a cube root of minus 125 is given. This minus 125 is not a positive rational number, so we had written here minus 125 is not a positive rational number. This first condition is not true here. Now second condition is cube root of minus 125 is coming minus 5, and minus 5 is not the irrational number, so that's why both the condition are not satisfying here, so we will say it is not a third. Now see part number 8 of this question. Question is square root of 3 plus square root 2. We have to check whether it is a third or not. So for third, first step is we have to check whether the given number inside the root is positive rational number or not. So first of all, we will check whether inside this root, this number is a positive rational number or not. What is inside this square root? Inside this square root, 3 plus root 2 is coming. 3 plus root 2. In this 3 plus root 2, square root 2 is coming. Square root 2 is a irrational number. So we will say that this full 3 plus root 2 term is irrational. So 3 plus root 2 is not a positive rational number. It is positive number, but it is not rational. It is irrational. That's why I had written here 3 plus square root 2 is not a positive rational number. And second condition is square root of this given number should be irrational. So what do you write? But square root of 3 plus root 2 is irrational. Why this is square root will be irrational? We had written here that 3 plus root 2 is a not a positive rational. This number is not a positive rational number. This is the irrational number. That means this irrational number we are taken in the square root, and the square root of irrational number will be irrational only. That's why I had written here square root of 3 plus root 2 is irrational. So these two conditions we have to check for third. First condition, the given number inside the root should be positive rational number, but here I had written not. That means first condition is not satisfying here. Second condition, the square root of that given number should be irrational. That second condition is satisfying, but first condition is not satisfying. So we will say that it is not a third, because for third, both the conditions should be satisfied. First one, that number should be positive rational number, and second thing, the square root, cube root, etc. of that given number should be irrational. If these two conditions will be true, then we will say that it is a third. Now, like this, you have to do all the remaining part of question number first. Now we will come to next topic. Next topic is how to find the lowest rationalizing factor. So next topic is rationalizing factor. So rationalizing factor, it is a number with which if we will multiply any irrational number, then the product of those two will be rational. What I said, suppose I have taken one irrational number 2 root 3. This is the irrational number. Why it is irrational? Because here root 3 is coming, and root 3 value we will not be able to find. That's why we will say it is irrational number. Now if we will multiply this irrational number with the square root of 3, so we will get the answer 2 into root 3 into root 3 will become 3. Final answer will be 6, and 6 is rational number. So what we had observed here, we had taken one irrational number and we had multiplied with root 3. So final answer came rational. So this number with which we had multiplied this 2 root 3, this number will called rationalizing factor. So rationalizing factor is a number with which if we will multiply the given number, then the product of these two numbers will be rational. Now we will solve some question based on this topic, rationalizing factor. Come to question number 2 of your textbook. Question number 2. Write the lowest rationalizing factor. Question is, we have to write the lowest rationalizing factor. Second part you see, part number second is square root of 24. Square root of 24 is given. First of all, what you have to do? We have to find the prime factor of 24. When we will find the prime factor of 24, we will get 2. We will get 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 3. Here these two pairs, this is a pair. This pair we will take outside the square root. This will become 2. Inside the square root, 2 into 3 will be there. So on multiplying this, we will get 2 root 6. So this 24 we can write 2 root 6 also. Now we have to find the lowest rationalizing factor. This is not a rational number. This is irrational number. Why it is irrational? Because root 6 is coming, and if we will find the square root of 6, answer will be non-terminating. This answer will not get finished. So this answer will be non-terminating and non-recurring. That's why this 2 root 6 is irrational number. Now in order to make this rational, we have to multiply it. We have to multiply this 2 root 6 with root 6. When we will multiply 2 root 6 with root 6, answer will become 2 multiply root 6 into root 6 will be 6. That means 12, and 12 is rational number. So this 12 is a rational number. How we get this 12? With the help of this root 6. So we will say that root 6 is the lowest rationalizing factor. So like this you have to do. See one more part. Part number 9. Ninth part. 3 root 2 plus 2 root 3. This is the question, and we have to write the lowest rationalizing factor. So in such question, what you have to do? In previous question, what is the question? Question is 2 root 6. Only one term was there. But here, two terms are there. First term is 3 root 2 and second term is 2 root 3. In previous question, what we had done? We had multiplied with root 6. But here, two terms are there. So for such question, you have to remember one thing. We have to take opposite sign number. That means 3 root 2 plus 2 root 3, we have to multiply it with 3 root 2 minus 2 root 3. This given number, we have to multiply it with opposite sign number. Here in between these two terms, plus sign is there. Now we will take minus sign. Why we are doing so? Because this will become one identity. 3 root 2 A. Suppose let's say this is 3 root 2 is A. So this 3 root 2 will also be A. 2 root 3, if we will say this is B, so this 2 root 3 will also be B. Here plus sign is there, so we will put here plus. Here minus sign is there, so we will put minus. So what you will observe? This is A plus B, A minus B. And we know the formula of this आइडेंटिटी ए प्लस बी ए माइनस बी इज इक्वल टू ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज ए प्लस बी ए माइनस बी. सो वी विल डू ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर. इंस्टेड ऑफ ए वी हैव टू टेक दिस फर्स्ट नंबर एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ बी वी हैव टू टेक दिस सेकेंड नंबर. नाउ वी विल डू स्क्वायर. स्क्वायर ऑफ थ्री विल बी नाइन. स्क्वायर ऑफ रूट टू विल बी टू माइनस. स्क्वायर ऑफ टू विल बी फोर. स्क्वायर ऑफ रूट थ्री विल बी थ्री. 9 to 18 minus 4 3 is 12. Now we will subtract these two. 6 is a rational number. So we got the final answer rational. So with the help of this number we got this rational. So we will say that root 3 root 2 minus 2 root 3 is a lowest rationalizing factor. So like this you have to do this question number 2. Now come to next topic. Next topic is how to rationalize the denominator. Next topic is rationalize the denominator. What is the meaning of this rationalize the denominator? Rationalize means we have to make rational. Where we have to make rational? In the denominator. In the denominator we have to make rational. So let's take one example. Example is 2 root 3 upon root 5. Here in the denominator what is given? Root 5 is given, and root 5 is a irrational number because square root 5 answer, if we will find, answer will be non-terminating and non-recurring. That's why we will say this square root 5 is irrational number. Now question is, we have to rationalize the denominator. That means in the denominator we have to make rational number. So what will be the first step? First step will be we have to multiply here with root 5. This is the irrational number. In order to make it rational, what we will do? We will multiply this root 5 with the root 5. So in the denominator, we have to take root 5. But the rule is that if we are dividing any number with the root 5, we have to multiply with root 5 also. This is the rule. So because of this root 5, this is the irrational number. We have to make it rational. Because of this root 5, we have to multiply and divide with root 5 here. So now we will solve it. 2 root 3 multiply root 5 will be root 15 upon root 5 multiply root 5 will become 5. So now we will check it. In the denominator what is coming? In the denominator 5 is coming, and 5 is a rational number. That means this answer is over. We had rationalized the denominator. So like this you have to rationalize the denominator. Let's take one more example. This is the question. We have to rationalize the denominator. In the denominator what is coming? 5 minus 3 root 2. In this term 5 minus 3 root 2, here root 2 is coming. Root 2 means it is a irrational number. So rationalize the denominator means here in the denominator we have to make rational number. So we have to multiply with 5 plus 3 root 2. This 5 minus 3 root 2 is the irrational number. So what will be the lowest rationalizing factor? In question number second I explained you how to find the lowest rationalizing factor. So 5 minus 3 root 2 is given. The lowest rationalizing of 5 minus 3 root 2 will be 5 plus 3 root 2. We have to take opposite side. So that's why we have to multiply this 5 minus 3 root 2 with 5 plus 3 root 2. Since we are taking this in upon, we have to take this same number in upside also. In the numerator also we have to take. This is the rule. Same number in multiply and in divide we have to take. Now next step. This is 5 plus 3 root 2. And this is also 5 plus 3 root 2. Both the number are exactly same. Each and everything with the sign. Everything is same. So if we will multiply x with x, answer will be x square. X multiply x is x square. In the same way, same number multiplied with same number, answer will be 5 plus 3 root 2 whole square. Now in the denominator, this is 5 minus 3 root 2 and this is 5 plus 3 root 2. That means a minus b, a plus b. So answer will be a square minus b square. So what we have done here, these two numbers are exactly same. So same number multiplied with same number means whole square. That's why we have taken here whole square. But here numbers are same but sign are different. Here in between these two minus is coming, between these two plus is coming. That's why what we had done, we had used one identity here, a minus b, a plus b. Answer is a square minus b square. Now next step, here we will use the formula. Which formula we will use? Formula we will use a plus b whole square. This is a and this is b. So a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. This is the formula which we have to use here in numerator. So what we will do? A square means 5 square plus b square means 3 root 2 square plus 2ab. 2 multiply a is 5 and b is 3 root 2 upon 5 square will be 25 minus 3 square will be 9. After 3 no sign is coming here, that's why we have to take multiply. Root 2 square we will do, and the square of root 2 will be 2 only. So what we have done here, here in the numerator we had used formula of a plus b whole square, a square plus b square plus 2ab. And in the denominator, 5 square is 25 minus 3 square will be 9. After that no sign is there, we had taken multiply. Square root 2 is given and whole square is also there. So on squaring it, we will get answer 2. Now next step, 5 square 25 plus 3 square will be 9. After that no sign is there, multiply. Root 2 square will be 2 plus 2 into 5, 10. 2 multiply 5, 10. 10 multiply 3, 30. Root 2 upon 25 minus 9 to the 18. Now what we will do? We will multiply this to 25 as it is plus 9 to the 18 plus 30 root 2 upon 25 minus 18, answer will be 7. Now we will add these two, 25 plus 18, 43 plus 30 root 2 upon 7. So this is the question, and in order to rationalize it, what we have to do? We have to check the denominator. We have to rationalize the denominator. So denominator we had checked. Here minus sign is coming. Opposite sign we had taken here. 5 plus 3 root 2 in the numerator also and in the denominator also. Then after that same number multiplied with same number will become whole square. A minus B, A plus B will become A square minus B square. Then after that we had solved and we got the final answer, this one. Now we will check in the denominator what is coming. 7 is coming. 7 is a rational number. So question is, we have to rationalize the denominator. So in denominator we are getting rational number. So like this you have to do question number 3rd. Now see question number 4. Question number 4 is, find the value of A and B. We have to find A and B. See part number 4. Question number 4. Fourth part. Question number 4th, 4th part is same, this one. So in question number 3rd, एंड इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 यू हैव टू यूज सेम मेथड. सो ओनली वन एक्स्ट्रा स्टेप इज इंक्लूडेड इन दिस क्वेश्चन 4th. व्हाट इज दैट? ऑन द राइट साइड ऑफ द क्वेश्चन 4th पार्ट इट इज गिवन a प्लस b रूट 2. क्वेश्चन इज गिवन 5 प्लस 3 रूट 2 अपॉन 5 माइनस 3 रूट 2 इज इक्वल टू a प्लस b रूट 2. सो व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, वी विल नॉट टेक राइट साइड, we will take left side and we will solve like this in the same way as we have done here. Till here you have to do as it is. Then after that what you have to do, this upon 7 we have to take in both, under both the numbers, under 43 also, 43 upon 7 plus this 7 we have to take under this number also, that means 30 root 2 upon 7. Like this you have to do, this upon 7 we have to take under both the numbers. Now after that we have to compare, we have to compare with, comparing with right side of the question. What is the right side of that question? Question right side is a plus b root 2. So if we will write here a plus b root 2, what we will observe here? Check these two answers. Instead of A, what is coming here? 43 upon 7. So we will say A answer is 43 upon 7. Plus sign is coming here. And here also plus sign is coming. So these plus sign we have to leave. Now with the root 2, what is here? B. But in the answer, with the root 2, what is coming? 30 upon 7 is coming. So that's why answer of B will be 30 upon 7. So like this you have to do question number 4. Now come to question number 6. In this question x is given, y is given, and first part is we have to find x square. So first step what you have to do, first of all, you have to take this x value. X is root 5 minus 2 upon root 5 plus 2. Most of the students are doing this mistake. Don't make this such mistake. X square is given, so they are putting here x square. Nobody will do like this. Answer will not come. So first step what you have to do is, first of all, we have to take x only. We will not do square. First of all, we will take x. And after that, you have to rationalize the denominator. What we have to do, first step is, we have to rationalize the denominator. In the denominator, root 5 is coming. Root 5 is a irrational number. Root 5 is irrational number. That's why we have to rationalize it. So first step is, we have to multiply it. Here, what is this? Root 5 plus 2. So opposite sign we have to take. That means root 5 minus 2. In the numerator also and in the denominator also, in order to rationalize it. So first step is we have to rationalize the denominator. Then we will get these two numbers are exactly same, root 5 minus 2, root 5 minus 2. So this will become root 5 minus 2 whole square. This is root 5 plus 2, this is root 5 minus 2. Sign, only sign difference is there. Here it is positive and here is it, here it is negative. So what we will do, we will use formula here, a plus b, a minus b. Answer will be a square minus b square. Now next step, we will open this square. Here we have to use formula. Which formula we will use? A minus b whole square. So a square plus b square minus 2 into a into b. Why I am taking here minus sign? Because this is a minus b whole square. This is the formula of a minus b. A minus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab. If here positive sign will be there, then we have to take positive. So because of this minus, we have taken here minus sign upon under root 5 square will be 5 minus 2 square will be 4. Square root 5 whole square is there. Answer will be 5 plus 2 square will be 4 minus 2 multiplied 2 will be 4 into root 5, that means 4 root 5 upon 5 minus 4 will be 1. On solving these two, 5 plus 4, 9 minus 4 root 5 upon 1 is not compulsory to write, so we will not write it. So now don't subtract these two numbers, 9 minus 4, we will not subtract, because in this term with 4 root 5 is also there, that's why we will not subtract these two. So x value we had rationalized, now we got the answer of x. Now we will find first part. First part is x square, that means x value is 9 minus 4 root 5 whole square. Now here we have to use this formula again, a minus b whole square, a square plus b square minus 2 into a into b. Now after that, 9 square will be 81, 4 square will be 16 into root 5 square will be 5 minus 2 into 9, 18, 18 4 ja 72 root 5. Now next step, we will multiply these two also, is equal to 81 plus 16 5 ja 80 minus 72 root 5. Now 81 plus 80 will become 161 minus 72 root 5. This is the answer of first part. Now in second part, he said we have to find y square. So y square also we have to find in the same way. First of all, what we will do, we will rationalize it denominator, then after that we will get such answer, then y square is equal to y value we have to put inside bracket, then we have to do square, and we will get the answer of y square, that will be 161 plus 72 root 5. In the same way you have to do this second part also. Now third part is we have to find xy. Xy means in between these two alphabets, no sign is coming, that means multiply. That means you have to do x multiply y. Value of x, we will not take these value, we will take this rationalized value of x. Rationalized value of x is 9 minus 4 root 5 into y value. Y value will be 9 plus 4 root 5. Now we have to multiply these two. Here we have to use formula. We can use identity, a minus b, a plus b, that will be a square minus b square. Then 9 square will be 81, 4 square will be 16 into root 5 square will be 5. So 81 minus 80, answer will be 1. So like this you have to do this part number 3. Now in part number 4, he said you have to find x square plus y square plus xy. In third part, we have to find x square plus y square plus xy. X square answer we had already find in first part. This answer we will put there. Y square answer also we had find here. We will put there. Then after that, x into y. So what do you have to do? X into y answer also we had already find, that answer also we will put there, and we will get the final answer of this part. So like this you have to do this question number 6. Now see question number 10. Question number 10, x value is given, x is equal to 5 minus 2 root 6, and we have to find x square plus 1 upon x square. So in such question, what you have to do? This term x square plus 1 upon x square you will get in one formula. If we will use x plus 1 upon x whole square formula, then we will get x square plus 1 upon x square plus 2 into x into 1 upon x, a plus b whole square, a square plus b square plus 2ab. So x plus 1 upon x whole square will be x square plus 1 square will be 1, x square will be x square plus these two x will get cancelled, 2. So the term which we have to find here, it is coming here, see, you cannot check it carefully. So what you have to do, first of all you have to find this value x plus 1 upon x, then only we will be able to solve this question. So first step is we have to find x plus 1 upon x. but we have to find x plus 1 upon x. X is already there. 1 upon x we are not having. We will find 1 upon x first. So 1 upon x means 1 upon 5 minus 2 root 6. But in this 1 upon x, root 6 is coming in the denominator. That means it is irrational number. So what we have to do? We have to rationalize the denominator first. So in order to rationalize it, we have to multiply with opposite sign number. 5 plus 2 root 6 in the numerator also and in the denominator also. So this will become 1 multiply 5 plus 2 root 6 will be 5 plus 2 root 6 upon 5 minus 2 root 6, 5 plus 2 root 6. Here we will use formula a minus b, a plus b. This will be a square minus b square. Now 5 plus 2 root 6 will remain as it is. 5 square will be 25 minus 2 square will be 4 multiply root 6 square will be 6. Now next step is 5 plus 2 root 6 upon 25 minus 6 4 ja 24. So answer is 5 plus 2 root 6. This is the answer of 1 upon x. But we will find x plus 1 upon x. Answer of x plus 1 upon x. X value is 5 minus 2 root 6 plus, this is the value of x, plus 1 upon x. 1 upon x answer we had find here. We will put here 5 plus 2 root. This is x. This is 1 upon x. Now what you will observe here? This is minus 2 root 6. This is plus 2 root 6. Both will get cancelled. So answer of x plus 1 upon x is 5 plus 5, 10. Now what will be the next step? We have to do squaring on both sides. What we will do? We will do squaring on both sides. So here also we have to take square and here also we have to take whole square. So this will become x plus 1 upon x whole square is equal to 10 whole square. Here also square and here also square. Here we will use identity formula a plus b whole square. A square plus b square plus 2ab, 10 square will be 100. Now x square plus 1 square will be 1, x square will be x square. These two x will get cancelled, plus 2 is equal to 100. Now what we will do? This plus 2 we will bring on right side. This will become 100 minus 2. On the left side it will be x square plus 1 upon x square. So final answer of x square plus 1 upon x square is 98. So like this you have to do such question. This is question number 10. Now see question number 14. Now see question number 14. Question number 14 is 4 minus root 5 upon 4 plus root 5 plus 4 plus root 5 upon 4 minus root 5. This is the question and we have to simplify it. So what we have to do here? We have to do this question in two parts. This part we will take separately. 4 minus root 5 upon 4 plus root 5. And what we will do? We will rationalize it. What we will do? In the denominator, irrational number is coming. Here in the denominator, irrational number is coming. So what we will do? We will rationalize the denominator. So what we will do? 4 minus root 5 upon 4 plus root 5. Opposite sign we will take. 4 minus root 5. 4 minus root 5. Now we will solve this and we will get the answer of this part. Similarly, we will do this second part also. What is given here? 4 plus root 5 upon 4 minus root. Here also in the denominator, irrational number is coming. So what we have to do? We have to rationalize it. In order to rationalize it, we have to multiply this full number with opposite sign here. 4 plus root 5 upon 4 plus root 5. And here also we will get answer as we got the answer here. So two answers we will get. So first part we will note this one and we will rationalize it. Second part we will note this one in the same way as we had done in previous questions. We will rationalize this part also. Then after that, after getting these two answers, what we have to do? We have to put these two values here. Suppose on solving this answer you got 2 plus root 5. Suppose. I don't know what will be the answer. I am just assuming. Assume that on solving it you will get 2 plus root 5. And on solving it you got 2 minus root 5. Then what you have to do? We have to put these two values here. So what do we have to do? We have to note down this question. 4 minus root 5 upon 4 plus root 5 plus 4 plus root 5 upon 4 minus root 5. This is the question. Now we will put these two values here. Answer of this is 2 plus root 5. So we will write here 2 plus root 5 plus answer of this is 2 minus root 5. Minus 5 and plus root 5 will get cancelled. So final answer will be 4. So like this you have to do this question number 14. This will not be the answer. I am repeating. This value I have taken myself. Exact answer I don't know. You have to solve it and you will get another values here. So like this you have to do question number 14. In the same way you have to do question number 5 and 11 also. It is same as question number 5 and 11. Now see one example of your textbook. Example number 20. Example number 20 is 1 upon under root 3 plus under root 2 plus 1. Sorry, here it is minus 1. So this is the question and he said we have to rationalize the denominator. In the denominator we have to rationalize it. So what will be the first step here in such question? Here three terms are coming. Root 3 plus root 2 minus 1. So in such questions you have to take these root numbers inside one bracket and another number without root we have to take separately. Now in order to rationalize this denominator, what we have to do? We have to take opposite sign number. What is this? 3 plus root 2 minus 1. So instead of minus 1, we will take here root 3 plus root 2 plus 1 upon root 3 plus root 2 plus 1. As we had done in the previous questions, all the questions what we had done, in the denominator, this minus this is written. So we have to multiply it with opposite sign number. So we have taken here plus. Now 1 multiplied with this number, answer will remain same. That means root 3 plus root 2 plus 1. But in the denominator we will use formula. This full is A. So this will also be A. 1 is B. So this one will also be B. So A minus B. A plus B. So this is one identity. A square minus B square. So what we will do? Root 3 plus root 2 square minus 1 square. Formula we had used. A square minus B square. Now this one number will be as it is. Root 3 plus root 2 plus 1. We have to do the square of this. Two terms are coming. So again we have to use one formula here. A plus B whole square. AX square plus B square plus 2 into A into B. So this much part we had solved for this term. Now after that what is written? Minus 1 square. Minus 1 square will be minus 1. Minus will be as it is. This minus sign will be as it is. 1 square will be 1. So like this you have to do. Now what will be the next step? Numerator will be as it is. Root 3 plus root 2 plus 1 upon square root 3 square will be 3. Under root 2 square 2. 2 into root 3 into root 2. This 2 will remain as it is. Root 3 into root 2 will become root 6. After that minus 1. Numerator will be as it is. Root 3 plus root 2 plus 1 upon 3 plus 2 will be 5. 5 minus 1 will be 4. Then this term is remaining. This we will write as it is. Now what you have to do? Here in the denominator, two terms are coming. Question is, we have to rationalize the denominator. We have to rationalize the denominator. So, in the denominator, still root 6 is coming. We had solved this question. We had rationalized also. But in the answer, root 6 is coming. And root 6 is not a rational number. It is irrational. Then that means we have to solve this again. We have to solve it again. So, two terms are coming. But in both the terms, we will observe that two we can take common. So, what we will do? We will take two common. Numerator will be as it is. Root 3 plus root 2 plus 1 upon out of 4 and 2 we will take 2 common. When we will take 2 common, so here it will be 2. This 2 we had already taken common, remaining number is root 6. Now in order to rationalize it, we have to multiply this. What is the numerator? Numerator will be as it is, root 3 plus root 2 plus 1 upon 2 bracket 2 plus root 6. In the denominator, root 6 is coming. In order to rationalize it, we have to multiply with the opposite sign number. 2 plus root 6 is given here in the denominator, but we will take 2 minus root 6 we will take in the numerator also and in the denominator also. Now what will be the next step? This number we have to multiply with this number. All are different. So in such question, what you have to do? First number is 2. This 2 we have to multiply with complete number. That means root 3 plus root 2 plus 1. As you had learned in 7th and 8th class multiplication method, horizontal method. That horizontal method of multiplication we will use here. So this 2 we have to multiply with full number. So 2 bracket this complete. After that minus 6 we have to minus root 6. This number also we have to multiply with full number. So in bracket we will write root 3 plus root 2 plus 1 upon. This 2 will remain as it is in the denominator. No need to touch this 2. This 1, 2 we will write as it is. Here we will use identity. Both are same. Only sign difference is there. This is a plus b. A minus b. So this will become a square minus b square. So 2 will remain here outside. And in the bracket we will take a square minus b square like this. Next step, 2 into root 3, 2 root 3. 2 into root 2, 2 root 2. 2 into 1, 2. Minus plus minus root 6 into root 3. Answer will be root 18. Minus plus minus root 6 into root 2 will be root 12. Minus plus minus root 6 into 1 will be root 6 divide 2 will be as it is, and in the bracket 2 square will be 4, root 6 square will be 6. Now what will be the next step? Next step is we have to find the prime factor of 18. 18 prime factor, 2 9 is 18, 3 3 is 9, 3 1 is 3. So root 18 answer we can write. These double 3 we will take outside the root. 3 root 2. So instead of root 18 we can take 3 root 2. Now 12. 2 6 is 12. 2 3 is 6. 3 1 is 3. These double 2 we will take outside the root. So square root 12 answer will be. These double 2 we will take outside. Single 3 we will take inside the root. 2 root 3. So what you have to do here now? 2 root 3 will be as it is. 2 root 2 will be as it is, root 2 will also be as it is, minus, instead of root 18, we will take 3 root 2, minus root 12. So instead of root 12, we will take 2 root 3, minus 2 root 3. Then after that, minus root 6. And in the denominator, 2 multiplied with 4 minus 6. 4 minus 6 answer will be minus 2. Now what will be the next step? Next step is we can cancel these two. This is plus 2 root 3 and this is minus 2 root 3. We will cancel these two. these two roots are same. What is this? This is square root 2. This is also square root 2. So we will solve these two terms. This is plus 2 square root 2 and this is minus 3 square root 2. Let's say this root 2 is x. That means this is plus 2x and minus 3x. So plus 2x and minus 3x answer will be minus 1x. So minus 1x. X means root 2. Now these two are solved. Which one are remaining? Plus 2 is remaining. Then minus root 6 is remaining. And in the denominator, 2 into minus 2 will be minus 4. Now what will be the next step? This minus we will take in the numerator, or directly you can change the sign of the numerator with the help of this minus sign. If we will remove this minus sign, so we have to change the sign of all the numerator number. So we can say this is plus ka root 2, this is minus 2, and this is plus root 6 upon 4. So this is the final answer of this question. So in the same way as we had done this example number 20, in the same way you have to do question number 12. Question number 12 of this exercise. So all the part of this exercise you have to do in your homework now. And exercise first D is the revision exercise only. All the parts of this first D exercise are also same as we had done in the previous exercise, first A, B and C. So this also you have to complete it in your classwork notebook.